Hello. Okay, welcome everybody. Sorry for the delay there. It was having trouble getting started. Okay, gonna check everybody in. We get to just relax and breathe. Welcome everyone. Welcome, April. So, if you're returning 7 p.m. yoga connoisseur, you know that you can leave your camera on or off. It's totally up to you. Hello, hello. And hopefully, in the email, you got to see that a bolster or a pillow is optional. Sometimes I just have to make sure the name on the screen is the same as the name. Would the person who's labeled as iPad mind putting in the chat just your name, just so that I can make sure I've got you? Not the end world. Okay, well, I think we'll go ahead and get started. If folks join in, that is totally fine. So tonight's practice, I thought it would be nice to kind of talk through our practice, or show through our practice how we can make a sequence on our own. Because I know for me, the beginning of quarantine, if you can even call it quarantine, I definitely noticed a need within myself to do a lot more yoga. But coming up with a sequence by myself was not the most comfortable thing. So I thought that we would use, this is not an ad or sponsored at all, but I do have these cards that I just got recently that I think are really great. They're just some asana cards. So basically, I'll show you how you could use some cards on your own. You don't have to buy cards or anything. You can just write some things down if you'd like, or you can ignore all of that and just do the practice as I say it. So it's totally up to you. But with that being said, just go ahead and find yourself in a comfortable place, maybe sitting on your pillow or your bolster. I have my little friend here with me just so that he doesn't walk in and out. He's gonna love the music, so I'm sure he'll just be fast asleep. Speaking of the music, though, if it's ever too loud, covers my voice, just pop a note in the chat. I'll try to make that a priority. All right, so coming out into the center of your space, wherever you are, we're just going to begin with some breath work. Just rolling the shoulders back and down. Option to close down your eyes if you'd like. Beginning to breathe deeper. Just noticing where you are tonight. And then beginning to notice the breath. How is the quality of breath? The work begins right here. Start by noticing, taking a scan through the body, noticing any bit of tension that you hold. I love the option of movement here right away. We don't have to be still. So if you find a spot of tension and you want to just circle around, focus on that spot and breathe into the tension. We begin to start to let that go. Our practice this evening is geared at opening the hips as well as the low back. So if you'd like to sit in a cross-legged position or maybe a butterfly pose, you can begin to gently start to open the hips. Continuing to straighten the spine with each exhale, reminding it to grow taller and longer. We're going to begin tonight with a pranayama technique, a breath technique called the moon breath. So this breath focuses on the lunar energy channel, something that is quite applicable to us in this evening practice. So we begin just from our comfortable seated position, again drawing our attention to the breath, maybe making it the loudest sound we can hear in the room. Amplifying the sound of that breath with the exhale, sealing the lips. Exhaling through the nose. And then gently bring your thumb and your forefinger right around the nostrils, kind of like you were going to pinch your nostrils. Just very gently. Continue to breathe there, not applying any pressure just yet. And we're going to practice breathing through just the left nostril, activating that lunar energy channel. So when you are ready, begin to seal that right nostril. And we're going to take 8 to 10 breaths through just that left nostril. Inhaling and exhaling through the left the whole time. Option for that balanced breath, the same length of inhale as an exhale, or if you'd like to take an exhale that's a little bit longer than your inhale, it'll help to calm the heart rate down. As you do this, visualize an energy channel running up from your spine through the left sit bone to your left nostril and feel the quiet energy between those two parts, left hip bone and left nostril. Feeling that energy travel up, feeling that nice air, calm and cool, as well as warm. Notice any sensations that come up. And after your last breath, we're just going to reverse, this time activating the sun breath. So after your last inhale and exhale through the moon channel, just take the forefinger, close the left nostril, and repeat that same process. Inhaling and exhaling through the right nostril this time. Again, activating that connection, this time between the right hip bone and the right nostril. Again, noticing anything that comes up or feeling the difference between each side. If at any point this becomes too much to close one nostril, you can always release the hands and just visualize this breath channel. Visualizing the breath coming through the right nostril, exhaling through the right. After your last cycle on this side, go ahead and release your hands. Just just bringing them down to the tops of the knees and taking 5 deep, deep breaths through both nostrils, exhaling through both. The deepest, longest breaths you've taken all day. Now recognizing where you are in your body, cultivating that calm as we continue on, we bring our hands to heart center, sealing in our intention for this practice. Maybe it's just to be here and now for the next 50 minutes we have together, or maybe it's something else. Whatever you are working on within yourself, within your mind, we seal that intention here with a breath om, just a very intentional exhale, sealing that intention into the heart space. We inhale together, exhale, beautiful. Flutter open your eyes if they aren't already open. And we're going to begin our practice coming onto our sit bones. So I'm going to give you a flow that we're going to do in between each posture. It's very simple, and this is something you can do on your own. If you don't know how to start a practice, just make a couple of moves, one into the next, and then do some postures and add that flow in between. It's a really great way to just release all the distractions of stressing about the sequencing. So coming onto our sit bones, we're going to bring our legs wide out into a straddle position. I'll bring the camera down just a tad. All right, so legs are wide. We know this stretch. We call this a wide angle seated forward fold. But we know this well. So basically our legs are as wide as we can get them without the knees and toes turning in as we send our torso forward. So our arms come out to a T. We inhale, reach over to one side. Exhale, come back up. Or as you switch to the other side, try the other breath pattern. Exhale as you bend over. And inhale as you come up. So we take this 5 times each side. It's easy to press into this stretch, but instead use the breath to help you get deeper. Speed doesn't matter. Only thing that matters is the deepening of the stretch coming from the breath. Beautiful. Finishing out our last rounds here. And then once you are finished, coming to stillness in the center, arms sweep overhead, hips stay open, curving down, knees and toes stay lifted to the ceiling. You can flex your feet to make sure that they are doing that. Arms come up and then we hinge forward. Coming to your edge, maybe this is a time where you bring your pillow and you use it not as a hindrance to this stretch, but rather a way to get deeper into the posture. This is a really challenging stretch. So just coming over and relaxing onto the pillow. Once you find your edge, we're just going to stay here for 3 full breath cycles. Option to pull the pillow further into your hips or further out, depending on how deep you want this stretch to be. And then after your last breath, as we're reaching for each other, just go ahead and press yourself back up. Knees are going to bend, but they're just going to go as wide as your pillow. Or if you don't have your pillow, you can come into a full butterfly position. So this is the third and final stretch of our little flow in between here. So one more time, we're going to reach our hands overhead and then hinge down. Noticing the difference here as your knees are bent. Notice if it gets into the side of the glutes a little bit more, maybe allows the low back to feel different somehow. Again, we're staying here for three breaths. Once you reach your edge, the top of the neck can curve over. Hands can come to the earth wherever they lay. And just releasing the head and neck, chin to chest, to allow some stretch in the upper back. After your last breath, go ahead and press yourself up. See if we can solidify those three postures in our mind, but no worries if not, we'll go through them each time. And then we're just gonna shift over into our first extended hold for this evening, a melting heart posture. So we're gonna come around into a tabletop position. Knees are under hips. And then instead of letting the hips rock backwards, we're just gonna walk our hands out, out, out. Knees and hips stay in that same alignment, but heart melts down. Coming to rest on the earth. Ideally, the chest will reach for the earth, maybe just right below your chin. But if not, it's a work in progress. We are aiming for a nice curve through the upper back, as well as a stretch through the side body and the shoulder joint. We're staying here for six breaths, so make them nice and slow, maybe still activating that memory of the sun or the moon breath. Maybe one sun breath, one moon breath. After your last breath, taking your time, we're going to gently press ourselves up into a counter pose before we find that same flow again. So in that tabletop position, just sit yourself back onto your heels. Option to have the toes untucked, or if you'd like to find a stretch through the heels, you can tuck the toes. I'm going to untuck because my feet have already been stretched quite a bit today. And from this posture, we're just going to start to walk ourselves back. Hands come behind the shoulders. This time, our same alignment of knees over hips, or hips over knees rather, applies to our arms. So shoulders are over wrists, stretching through the quads, through the shoulder joint, actively pressing the shoulder blades behind. It should feel like a nice chest opener. We're here for six breaths. Make them nice and slow.
Beautiful. Really stretching through the arms, you may feel, especially in the biceps. And then gently, after your last breath, start to walk yourself up, bringing your legs around in front of you, wide angle. We begin that same flow. So arms come out to a T. This time, I'm going to exhale over to one side. I prefer that. And then inhale back through center. Exhale, other side. Again, going at your own pace, 5 rounds each side. And you'll notice as we come back to this flow, that you may find deepening in each stretch. Working to align that breath and movement. Beautiful. After your last one, we're coming down into that wide angle, seated forward fold. Option to use that prop if you'd like. Find yourself in your edge on your own time, and we stay for 3 breaths. Pressing yourself up when you are ready. Coming into your last of the 3 postures, a butterfly pose, or hugging the bolster pose, we'll call it. One more time, you find your edge for 3 breaths. What a joy it is to be able to practice alongside with everyone. Go ahead and press yourself back up. We're coming into our next flow here. Start to remove your props. Unless you know that you'd like to use it, again, to get a little bit more gently into the hips, we're coming into a wide-legged child's pose, or wide knee, I should say. So knees come as wide as you feel comfortable with. Option to just find yourself in your child's pose if you know it well, or that pillow can go right in between and you can sit yourself down, torso rests on the bolster or pillow. This is an option if that kind of pinching through the hips as you reach your edge is feeling uncomfortable. But we are deepening into our hips with each stretch, so you might be able to get rid of it. We're here for 6 breaths, nice and slow. And the wider your knees are, the more you're gonna feel it in the inner hip area. So if it's a little bit too much, just make the knees a little bit more narrow. Option is always to bring the knees completely together, if that feels best. Just resetting the hips in a closed hip position. Making sure that the hips press back, releasing any pressure on the knees. The the arms and the hands are outstretched in front so that you can use a little bit of pressure if you need to guide the hips backwards, reminding the knees to release the brunt of the weight, sending it rather into the hips. Beautiful. After your last breath, gently come on up. We're coming with our legs in front into a caterpillar stretch. So yes, this is a closed hip position, both hip points facing forward, but sometimes in our wide-legged forward fold, we find that our hamstrings are the place that is holding us back. So in this position, again, you can use the pillow if you'd like. We're just gonna take a nice forward fold, almost as if we were standing. Exhaling into the fold, finding your edge, maybe grabbing around the feet, or if you'd like, placing the pillow on top of your legs to help relax into that stretch. Again, we are here for 6 breaths. Primary focus is releasing the hamstrings. So if you feel something else that is not good, go ahead and adjust, pivot that position so that the hamstrings can receive all of your attention. Get a little bit of a break here. Maybe this helps you access the low back in a new way. Continuing to deepen that breath, using the visualization if it helps. Or letting it go if it doesn't. After your last breath, take your time and press yourself back up, releasing the pillow. We're coming again into that trio of stretches. So bringing our legs wide. Now this is the 3rd time we've been here, so see if this feels any better or any deeper. Hands come out to a T, inhale in the center, and exhale over to one side. Ooh, I found some deepening right away. I hope you did too. Off to the other side. It's amazing what simplicity can do. Sometimes the routines we feel best in are ones that we just know so well because we do the same thing every day. Now we may feel like we're doing the same thing every day in different ways, but tonight's practice is a reminder that it's okay to repeat. It's okay to circle back. Realized how much we've grown. How resilient we are. How we can do something we never thought we could do. After your last one, legs stay where they are. Maybe this time you try it without the pillow, your choice. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, fold forward, but knees and feet stay exactly where they are. If they start to turn in or fall inwards, you can narrow the legs just a little bit, or just stop at that point where they turn in. That is your edge. 3 breath cycles here. Start to walk yourself up when you are finished. And then just bending the knees, last stretch. Maybe you find a full butterfly this time. Oh, found a nice pop. Inhale, arms overhead. And exhale, three breath cycles. Find your edge. Keeping in mind the knee position, knee health is so important as we do open hip stretches. It's easy to accidentally torque the knees a little bit. Just paying attention to how you feel. It goes so long. Such a long way. After your last breath, gently press yourself up. I'm going to use my mat for this next series. If you have a mat, maybe you bring it out, or maybe you're already using it. We're going to begin in a downward facing dog. So we begin from a tabletop position. Go ahead and tuck the toes back. And very slowly, because this is an inversion still, we're going to send our hips high to the sky. And spend three breaths in this first down dog. Again, activating the hamstrings, but in a different way. Now we have the leverage of our arms to help press backwards ever so slightly. Where's your breath? Can you deepen it? Can you make it louder as distractions come in? And the breath be the most important thing. After your last breath, gazing forward, inhale, right leg comes high to the sky, hips square to the earth. Exhale, bring it through, step it in between the hands, and then lower the back knee. We're coming into a lizard posture, or option to take a pigeon if you would like. So if you'd like to stay for the lizard, then both hands are going to come inside your front leg. So closer to your torso. And then that front foot starts to peel just to the outside of the foot. Starting to feel that opening through the front hip, maybe as well as the back hip flexor. Or if that doesn't feel good or you'd prefer to take a pigeon, you can just walk that front foot over just slightly, coming down onto the knee, bringing that foot parallel, trying to keep the hips square to the earth and not sitting over to one side, taking your stretch, whatever feels best tonight. If neither of those feel good, you can simply stay in that low lunge, stretching the opposite hip flexor. We're here for three breaths. After your last breath, gently walk yourself back. And then instead of that big sweeping motion, we're just going to bring that knee back to tabletop. Go ahead and take a couple of circles through the hips to reset. A couple circles one way, then the opposite way. Once you find some stillness in the center, tuck the toes. We're sending our hips high for one more downward facing dog. Maybe you find something different in this second down dog that you didn't find before. Maybe it's a stretch through the calves. Two more breaths here. And the then once you are finished, inhale opposite leg. For me, it's my left. And exhale, sweep it down, send it through. Coming to that low lunge. Now, ideally, we would find the same stretch as we did on the other side, but our bodies can be totally different from one side to the next. So go ahead and test out that stretch that felt good on the other side. Option to stay there, or if it doesn't feel good, adjust and do something else. You can take lizard, you can take pigeon, with that foot coming over to that long edge of the mat, or you can just stay in the low lunge. We're here for 3 breaths. Lengthening that back hip flexor as well as the side of the front glute. If you're walking yourself down, maybe you're in your lizard or your pigeon, you might find a little bit of stretch through the low back. Your last breath, go ahead and walk yourself back up very gently, coming back into a tabletop. Couple hip circles one way and then the other. And then once you are finding some stillness, press yourself up to a kneeling position. We're just going to sweep the arms behind the back, finding a chest opener. We've done a lot of work compressing this hip area. Now we're just going to release the chest. Arms sweep behind the back, almost like the start of a camel pose. Hands can stay down by the hips, or if you'd like to extend them back, finding more stretch through the shoulders and the biceps. Do that. 2 more breaths here, and then we find a camel pose. So for those eager for that back bend, it's coming if you'd like it. Last exhale, start to walk your hands back. Maybe you find your heels. Gently, gently starting to release the head. 3 breaths. Gently walk yourself up. Go ahead and sit back down onto the heels. 1 clearing breath here, releasing anything that came. And then rolling through the shoulders. We're coming down onto our seat 1 more time. Final flow through these 3 postures. Knowing that it's the last time, can you make it the deepest one yet? Or at least see where you are. Inhale, arms come out to T. Exhale over to one side. Inhale back up and exhale other side. Now, because this is the last time and because we've done this many times before, maybe you pivot again. Maybe that resilience, that strength that you've built through all these past few months tells you that when you find a better option for yourself, you're gonna take it. So maybe you extend onto one side and you just hold and stay there for a whole breath cycle. After your last breath, find that wide angle seated forward. Three breaths at your edge. Inhale, arms overhead. And then exhale, three breaths at your edge, last time. Gently walking yourself back up. Pivoting around, and this time pivoting with your body. I've said pivot a lot. Sending your legs in front very gently and slowly. We're going to roll onto our backs for some spinal twists. So arms come out front if you'd like, or they can stay by your sides. And gently, gently, you're going to start to roll down one vertebra at a time until you reach the mat. Arms go long by your sides, bending the knees in. Just start to windshield wiper side to side. We've done a lot of curving through the low back. It may take us a minute here to find that neutral position in the low back. So take your time. Beautiful April, I love the changing speeds. I love that choice you've made. Once your low back is starting to feel more neutralized, bring the knees to the center. And then exhale them over to one side. Finding a gentle spinal twist here, gazing towards the opposite side. We're here for six breaths. It's a long time. But oftentimes a spinal twist doesn't really do it for us unless we stay here a little bit longer. So releasing through that top hip, releasing any hold to the hip flexors. Allow the knees to drop further to one side. As your head gazes or your eyes gaze towards the opposite side, there we start to feel the low back waking up. Feeling that compression through the digestive organs. Last breath, very gently, using the core, start to bring the knees back to the center, core strength rather than momentum, and then hands grasp in front of the knees, just rock side to side like a tight little ball, and then stopping in stillness in the center, we're going to rise the legs high, to grab the feet or maybe behind the knees. We're coming into a happy baby. Our inversion for tonight, other than our downward dog. Really pulling the knees into the space of the armpit. This is still an open hip posture, really opening through the inner thighs. Option to take a lower child's pose. If you'd like, you can bring the feet down, knees are still bent, but just rocking side to side. If that helps you find more activation, less pressure in the hips, take whatever variation feels best to you. We're here for 3 more breaths. Once you are finished with your last exhale, go ahead and inhale, bringing knees back towards the center, and exhale, bring them to the opposite side. We find our spinal twist, other side. Again, coming into this posture from the same entrance, just to try it, but knowing that both sides of our body can be completely different. So maybe you switch this up somehow. Maybe you don't gaze over the opposite side if that's feeling like a strain. More breaths on this side. Nice deepening, deepening breaths. Allowing the heart rate to come down. Feeling gratitude for this time you've taken for yourself. Knowing that that is the best gift you could give yourself. After your last exhale, gently, gently using the core to bring yourself back to center, squeezing the knees into a tight ball one last time. And then exhaling, sending the legs long, coming into your favorite resting pose. So maybe that's a full Shavasana, lying down on your back. Toes falling open, hands open to the sky. Or maybe you'd like to involve your pillow or your bolster somehow. I love to place it under my knees so that my low back can reset. Instead of curving this way, it starts to curve back under. Grabbing a blanket if you know that you get cold. Once you arrive there, just start to scan the body. Now in your own practice, sometimes it can feel daunting to do a self-guided meditation for one. But you can always just come back to a simple body scan, knowing that what we practice on this mat helps us practice these skills for our daily lives. Sometimes a body scan can be the most important thing to practice. Because we know we can always do a body scan, however hectic our day is. We can always take 2 seconds to scan and to release. If you find any bit of tension along this scan, from the toes all the way up through the crown of the head. Pause there. Take an intentional inhale and exhale to release that tension the best you can. If your body feels fine, like the body scan isn't helpful, option to take one breath dedicated to each major part of the body. So bringing your awareness to the soles of your feet, relax the soles of your feet. Inhale, bringing your awareness to the tops of your feet. Exhale, relax the tops of your feet. And continue to travel upwards. Inhale, bringing awareness to the calves. Exhale, release the calves. Continue up slowly and methodically, working your way up your body, feeling each individual body part, relaxing it from the legs, torso, to the arms, neck, and head. When you reach the head and face area, relax the space in between your eyebrows. Release the tongue off the top of your mouth. Those are two areas that almost always tense up. Soften the crown of your head. And once you've completed your scan, feel your entire body from head to toe relaxed, soft, notice each place where you come into contact with the ground, where you feel the ground beneath you. Feel that support. Relax deeper into that support as if you were melting into the ground. To the earth, we begin our silent breath work just for you. Thank you. Hands to heart center. We seal our practice with one final breath of gratitude, sending it to the heart space, letting it live there. Gratitude for taking the time for yourself. Gratitude for all the things you do, even though it's hard. All the things you do to try to live better each day. Taking this time, setting this time aside for yourself. And gratitude for anything else that your heart calls tonight. One final breath. Inhale. Exhale, let that gratitude live in the heart space, thanking yourself, loving. Thank you for sharing your energy with us this evening. It was my honor to be in this space with you. Namaste. Thank you all so much for joining. Please leave any comments or feedback, hello, that you have. Let me know about the music. I'm trying to evolve every week, so different setup this time, and hopefully it was better, but let me know. Thank you so much. And these cards that I mentioned earlier, I promised I wouldn't give too much of a spiel about them, but you can use pictures like this to create a little trio for yourself or whatever you want. You can write it down. And if you're ever struggling with how to make a practice on your own, do something similar to what we did tonight. Make a little set, do a posture or a series, and then do the set just as your reset in between each one. Hopefully that helps. As always, send any questions you have, any feedback, and hope to see you again very soon. Thank you so much. Oh, April, I'm sorry. I should have been quieter. That's the hard thing about announcements at the end. Like, I want you to stay in Shavasana forever, and then I talk a million things, you know?
I fell asleep.
Oh, that's great. That's perfect.
I heard talking, and I was like, oh, wait, I think it's over.
No, that's great. That's the goal. That's what they always say in person, right, is the goal is to fall asleep. Thank you so much. Well, have a wonderful evening.
Have a great night.
Thank you.